Sports. Hi, everyone. I'm Brian Anderson, alongside Grant Hill and Clark Kellogg. Our reporter is Ali LaForce. So, the opening lineup for the Timberwolves. Inside, we got Towns and Gobert. Edwards at the two with McDaniels at the three. And it's Conley in at the point. And for the Bucks, at small and power forward, it'll be Middleton and Giannis. Damian Lillard out there with Malik Beasley. And it's Lopez in at the five. Well, Grant, something these teams have in common is their phenomenal rebounding ability. Who do you see winning the battle on the boards?
You know, it could go either way. I mean, frankly, sometimes there's an element of luck on the glass. So we'll just have to see whose way the ball is going tonight.
Now here's Gobert. Back to Conley. Takes the assist and lays it in. Nice setup.
Gobert can look over the top of just about any defense right there. Delivers a nice pass.
Antetokounmpo.
I'll tell you what, it's good to be his age.
Yeah, I don't have memories like that at my age, though.
Yeah, it does make me look back a little bit, but I could never throw it down like that. It sure does look good.
Well, Clark, we know Anthony Edwards is a great hooper, but how would you rate his acting ability?
Hey, I thought he was quite good. To be honest with you, B.A., in that Hoops movie, he was playing the bad guy, the villain role. Ant has a huge personality. We saw that on the big screen. Perhaps a second career for him when he's done
shooting,
terrorizing
two.
The NBA.
And the first one at the line is good.
Hey, like a lot of guys, Edwards rides momentum as a player. When his confidence is soaring, so is his activity level.
Both good from the line that time. Well, Grant, how do the Bucks put the pieces back together and make a run at another title?
Well, the hope is this new coaching staff will unlock some new wrinkles and find ways to keep their offense from stalling in the clutch. This dude is capable of some memorable moves. He's showing off and having a little fun.
Now Conley, taking a look at his numbers, averaging about 11 a game. Rejected by Lopez. And that'll be Minnesota's ball as it goes out of bounds. Timberwolves able to keep the possession. Outside McDaniels. Kicks it out, Towns. Puts up a three. Gets the three to fall.
It's a real challenge, a major challenge to face a big man who can shoot like Towns can. He stretches the floor as well as any big guy in the league.
Now here's Lillard. A proven scorer in this league, averaging just over 25 a game.
Just taking it right to the rim, and no one was there to greet him.
Well, this early, they should be showing a lot more energy on defense. It's not there.
Lillard against Conley. Towns passes to Conley. And that one goes out of bounds. Last touch by Lillard. Here's Towns. And the basket is good. Towns has got five.
Karl Anthony Towns finishing through contact there.
Lillard with the ball. And it's Gobert picking him up. Puts up the eight-footer. Another one falls for Milwaukee.
I love the execution we are seeing thus far. Four shots and four makes.
Grant, some think of Gobert as just a defensive specialist. But he's proven to be more than that.
Yeah, B.A., I like how Rudy uses his height to his advantage inside. Focuses on taking high percentage shots that come to him naturally.
I'll tell you, McDaniels eats up ground in a hurry.
here in the first. Just under 2.5 minutes played so far. Here's Middleton. Count it. 1-for-1 to start the game.
Boy, at the offensive end, his game is so impressive. I mean, he's a threat every time up the floor.
From 12 feet, and he'll draw the foul. He'll head to the line for two. They pin that one on Giannis Antetokounmpo.
Anthony Edwards has a great body and knows how to control it. Showing you right there by taking advantage to draw the foul. Shooting two.
He's off on the first. And it's a completely new group for the Bucks. And a new group getting ready for the Timberwolves. Reeves checked in for Gobert. Anderson comes in for Towns. Alexander Walker, he's checked in for McDaniels. And Milton subbed in for Mike Conley. And he's good on the second. The Bucks trail. And here's Payne, averaging around 6 a game. To the inside. And he was camped in the lane there. He gets a 3-second call. And a quick look here at some of the numbers for Chris Middleton. The Timberwolves have gone 4-of-5 so far, looking sharp. 1:02 left to play in the first. Here's Edwards. They get it back. For Milwaukee, they've gone 5-of-5 in this quarter. Solid. Knocked loose. And that's out of bounds. Milwaukee will retain possession. Pass to Beauchamp. Out to the wing. Payne against Milton. The shot by Payne, no good. Minnesota in the lead. And we're just over 3.5 minutes into this first quarter. And Edwards with the basket on the assist by Anderson. Payne against Milton. Right side Payne. That one doesn't drop. Ooh, good work defensively by Milton. Now here's Edwards. Here's Alexander Walker. And the Timberwolves hit again from deep. And so it's the Minnesota Timberwolves with a 6-point lead at the close of the quarter. Great shot selection right now, keeping the game simple and getting high percentage looks. We'll be right back with you shortly. For those of you just tuning in, second quarter action is where we are. And a moment now to quickly take a look at the offensive approach for Minnesota.
Well, you got to be impressed with how selfless they've been so far. Their passing has been simply outstanding.
Something else they're doing well tonight, guys? Lots of points in the paint. Something to continue to keep our eye on.
Well, the saying is defense wins championships. But in this day and age, don't you need both?
No question, B.A., you definitely do. I mean, we've seen plenty of great defenses flame out in the playoffs because they couldn't put up points. Defense alone isn't enough. You need a balance of both.
On the court for the Timberwolves. Edwards at the two with McDaniels at the three. Inside, we got Towns and Gobert. And it's Conley in at the one. Just 5 to shoot. Towns against Antetokounmpo. The shot by Towns, no good.
Defense made an impact right there. Definitely got him uncomfortable going up with it.
And he lobs it up to the rim. On the break. Here's McDaniels. And he jams it home with authority.
Capable of finding his open guys. Edwards getting better at improving his overall floor awareness. Nice to see.
Middleton, no good.
Man, I can't believe he blew that gimme, guys. Well, I know he's frustrated about that.
Rejected by Antetokounmpo.
No mercy shown that time on D by Giannis.
Great rejection.
And so he draws the foul, headed to the line to shoot a pair.
Man, good whistle there.
Yeah, you can hear the smack all the way over here where we are.
Free throw good. Lillard.
Yeah, I think something that doesn't get appreciated enough is Lillard's patience. But he's not one to rush things or look for easy outs. He knows it takes hard work to succeed.
Lopez, he's checked in for Portis. So after making the first, he goes 1 for 2. Well, Clark, no question which end of the floor Rudy Gobert makes his biggest impact.
Yeah, he's a demoralizing defender. I mean, his height and reach give him some significant advantages, but it's more than that. You don't win multiple Defensive Player of the Year awards just because you're tall and long. You got to have some toughness. You got to have some anticipation and timing and the willingness to get down and dirty.
And let's swing it over to the sideline and hear from Allie.
Hey, Brian. Well, Giannis Antetokounmpo says his greatest challenge lies within. He said, quote, "I don't compete with others. I just compete with myself. Every other night, it's going to be another great player, but I just try to be consistent, have fun, enjoy the game, create art, and be the best I can be."
Artistry. I like it, Allie. Thank you.
Using his size advantage there to rip down that board in traffic.
Antetokounmpo, the pass to Lillard. Oh, Lillard shrugs off the contact.
Come on, man. Did you see? I mean, just using his strong frame to absorb the contact and still able to finish? Wow.
And the Timberwolves call time here. And when it comes to Giannis Antetokounmpo, such a lovable player on and off the floor, Clark.
Yeah, he really is. I mean, he's just such a carefree, gregarious, outgoing personality. Somebody that doesn't take himself too seriously. And he likes to tell his fair share of dad jokes, too, which is pretty endearing.
Connaughton, he's checked in for Milwaukee. Beauchamp comes in for Beasley. And the Timberwolves will go for a different look here. Reeves checked in for Rudy Gobert. Anderson comes in for McDaniels. Alexander Walker, he's checked in for Edwards. And Milton subbed in for Mike Conley. Towns for three. The rebound by the Bucks.
The shooter thought he had enough space, but the defender was right on him.
You know, that's a trademark of his defense. Quick to react, close down the shooter, and then affect the shot.
To the paint. Here's Reed. A slam dunk by Reed.
And that's what happens when you don't take care of the ball.
Hey, that makes the turnover hurt even more.
What? You mean the throwdown at the end? I'll tell you what, fellas. I mean, the highlight shows are going to pain them even more.
Lillard outside. Let's go with a three. Alexander Walker grabs the board. The Timberwolves have gotten 5 of 8 attempts to drop since the second began. Outside, Anderson. Pass to Milton. Now here's Reed. Goes to the fadeaway. Reed's gotten 4 this quarter.
And another great assist. The offense is really clicking now.
You know, the defense has really been kept off balance because of the outstanding pass. 4 straight field goals have been made off an assist.
Antetokounmpo with it. Drives to the hoop. Giannis muscling through.
Nice concentration from Giannis Antetokounmpo. Outstanding job looking over the defense and staying focused on the basket.
And so it's the Minnesota Timberwolves with a 9-point cushion at the end of the quarter, appearing in control, but could still use a little more of a push to feel totally comfortable in this one. Well, now a minute to check in with Allie LaForce. She's courtside. Hey, Allie.
Thanks. I'm here with Doc Rivers and Coach. I know you cannot be happy with this team's play in the first half. What will you tell them they need to improve on?
The score and our effort, our offense. They're just playing harder. They're more physical. They're tougher. Honestly, we're very lucky right now.
Lots to improve on in the second half. Thanks, Coach.
Thanks very much, Allie. We'll be back soon to start the second half of basketball.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey again, everybody. I'm Ernie Johnson. Shaq is here. Kenny's here. You're watching the NBA Halftime Show on 2K Sports. It's Minnesota out in front at the half. They have a 9-point lead. How about you, Shaq? What did you think about Minnesota?
Well, what I like, the ball never stopped moving, nor did the players. Everyone working in unison, playing for one another. Love to watch this brand of basketball. We've got a whole other half to go. I'm so excited.
And over to Kenny, your thoughts on the Bucks?
Well, it's never fun. When you're playing against a team that's on fire. This team was on fire. They showed effort on defense, but it didn't matter. They couldn't get the stops. I don't think the opponent could sustain this kind of shooting.
And that'll about do it as we get ready for the second half. Let's take you down to Kevin Harlan.
Shout out to my main man, Joel.
Joel, what up?
And we've got third quarter basketball here. Two quarters in the books. Wow, Damian Lillard really having a great game.
You just love his patience offensively in the first half. Waited until he got the looks he wanted.
Well, you know what, guys? It was all about efficient offense, not rushing things. Taking your time, finding the best shot on every possession.
And happy you could join us. We've got two quarters left to go in regulation. Giannis and Lopez together down low. Filling out the wings, it's Beasley and Middleton. And it's Lillard in at the point. That's Doc Rivers 5 as we get into the second half. Now here's Conley. Here's Towns. That one's good. And it's Conley who picks up the assist. Towns has got 7.
Their offense is really humming right now, and it's because of the beautiful ball distribution.
10 straight points off assist. That's very impressive. And it also makes the game easy and fun to watch.
Here's Middleton. He's been contributing over 15 a game. Over McDaniels. And that one's good. Middleton.
Man, I tell you what, Middleton does a nice job using his length inside. You know, when he gets in a good spot, he's a high percentage shooter from there.
Got it. He's got 9.
That's 3 buckets in a row off assist.
And Milwaukee's shooting 53%. Good efficiency on offense so far. Pass to Lillard. Just owning the paint.
Time and time again, they're creating good looks from close range.
And even under pressure in close, I think they've still done a good job maintaining concentration and converting the opportunities.
Edwards for 3. Antetokounmpo grabs the board. The Bucks have got 2 of 3 from the floor in this third quarter. Knocks it loose. Here's McDaniels. From down in the low post, it goes. McDaniels got his 3rd basket of the night.
A nice start to the third. 3 out of 4 and looking good doing it.
Well, Clark, with his mix of power and length, at times Giannis can seem unstoppable.
You know what? Not often is it that one guy forces teams to reconsider their whole defensive game plan. But Giannis forces you to build the wall because you don't want him getting downhill or he'll make you suffer the consequences.
And Clark with Malik Beasley. He's someone who can really light it up offensively.
Yeah, you know, he can shoot it off of movement, off the dribble pull-up, or he can take it all the way to the rack. I think he's much more than just a spot-up 3-point shooter.
Anderson's checked in for Towns.
Find the lane. One shot.
The free throw off from Beasley.
You know, when Beasley stays within himself, I think he's really an effective player. And We know he's skilled on offense.
Anderson finds Edwards. Stolen by Middleton. And out of bounds, Minnesota will have it. As we get deeper into the season, the Eastern Conference standings are really taking shape. Let's take a look. Taking a look at Milwaukee, sitting pretty at this point of the season, second place and looking to move to first.
Well, I think for Milwaukee, I recall them having a lot of naysayers at the start of the season, but now they may not have any. This team is ready for a deep playoff run.
They do have the pieces in place for a title run, but the competition in the playoffs will be stiff.
And they'll get another chance. Back to Middleton. Fades and shoots. The rebound by the Timberwolves. Anderson's got four rebounds now. Outside McDaniels. Back to Conley. From downtown. Nails it from beyond the arc. Conley's got five.
Well, Conley can be a volume scorer from the arc. The defense can't let him just have those opportunities.
Time called here. The Bucks decide to talk it over. Well, he may not be a flashy player, but Kyle Anderson is a winner, Clark.
He really is. I mean, he's selfless, understands how to play. You hear that said a lot. It's about IQ. It's about feel, understanding. Gets it done at both ends of the floor, and I love the fact that he's a tremendous playmaker at 6'9".
A different look for Milwaukee. Connaughton, he's checked in for Middleton. And it's Beauchamp in for Beasley. Reeds checked in for the Timberwolves. Alexander Walker comes in for Edwards. Portis, the pass to Beauchamp. There's 53 seconds left in the third. Misses from close range. Here's Anderson. And that one's good. A nice job on the glass as they picked up two on the second effort.
That'll drive your coach crazy, failing to box out. Ugh.
Those are free points you're giving away. You gotta work harder on the glass.
Now here's Portis. No points yet. Back to Payne. To end the run. No luck on that one. Nice D from Reed. And it's Conley with the ball for the Timberwolves. 16-point lead, the largest margin in the game.
And the shooter had very little space on that attempt.
And guys, that's exactly the kind of high-impact defense they want to see out of him.
Now Anderson. And so it's Minnesota in control with a 16-point advantage heading into the break. They're getting quality looks, and that's why they're shooting at such a high clip. We're coming right back. Don't go anywhere. And it's time now to bring you our State Farm assist of the game.
Yeah, just shredding the defense with that feed. Zero chance to stop that.
Yeah, that's just a brilliant read of the defense. I mean, it was also excellent anticipation of the movement of his teammates before the pass. Just great harmony on all sides.
And we reach the fourth quarter in a game that may already be out of hand. Minnesota has gotten three of their seven threes to find the net in this matchup. And a look now at the five for the Timberwolves to start the fourth quarter. Edwards and Anderson are out on the wing. They have their two big men out there, Towns and Gobert, working inside. And it's Conley in at the point guard position. Now here's Beasley. Antetokounmpo. Carl Anthony Towns comes up with a rebound. Beasley against Edwards. And stolen by Beasley. Oh, and a fast break for the Bucks. Oh, and the jam by Giannis.
And when the Greek Freak takes flight, I mean, he's looking to tear that rim apart. So ferocious in his throwdown.
There's the AT&T 5G Slam Cam capturing the moment. Edwards looking for an opening. And Edwards slams it in.
Now that's how you use the screen right there.
And it leads to a thunderous finish. That was nice.
And, you know, not enough help from the defense there to compensate. He gets a clean look, and that's exactly how you draw it up.
Now here's Antetokounmpo. And here's Lillard from beyond the arc. And it's Gobert with a rebound. Gobert's got 6 rebounds in the game. Conley up top, defended by Lillard. Outside Edwards. Back to Conley. Takes the 3. The rebound by the Bucks.
That's staying connected to the shooter and timing the contest.
And Beasley gets it to go on the assist by Antetokounmpo.
You know, a marksman like Beasley, not thrown by a little bump. He stays committed and gets his shot off.
Outside, Anderson. Pass to Gobert. Shoots over Lopez. Gobert, no good. The Bucks have gotten half of their attempts to fall in the fourth. 2 for 4 now. The feed! The jam! Giannis!
How about the springs of this guy, Antetokounmpo, also known as the Greek Freak? I mean, he just gets up off the ground like a rocket on these alley-oop chances.
Another miss by Minnesota.
And you just can't afford to give up that kind of look very often.
Beasley finds Middleton. Antetokounmpo outside. Over Towns. Antetokounmpo can't connect.
Clearly the defense could have been better there, guys, but he also needs to convert that.
Around 3 minutes gone here in the fourth. Outside Edwards. Finds the bottom from 13 feet out. And the Timberwolves lead by 14.
Little to no chance they're able to overcome this deficit. Going to be a good victory for the Timberwolves.
Offensively, they made the most of their trips.
They found multiple ways to score consistently. And a little luck doesn't hurt them either. They also got some nice bounces off the rim tonight, too.
And for the year now, they've chalked up 35 wins.
And having this win on the books might give them a little mental advantage the next 2 times these squads meet.
The stats tell us that the winner of the first game is a big favorite to come out on top in the overall series.
And it was a reliably solid performance from one of their key guys. A tremendous game for Rudy Gobert.
Oh, I liked how he mixed it up on the glass. Wasn't afraid to get in there and do the dirty work. Showed some real grit and toughness tonight.
Mind the lanes. Mind the lanes. One shot.
That's good from Beasley. 16 seconds left in the fourth. Milton surveys the floor. And so it's Minnesota easily grabbing this one. It ends up being a fairly easy road win.
Those are so hard to come by. It's never easy to take a game in someone else's building.
And now we have Allie LaForce standing with the player of the game. Allie, take it away.
Rudy, you guys came to play tonight. Can you talk about the motivation right from the opening tip?
We just wanted to have a good defensive game. you know, come out ready and make sure we communicate and run back, because these guys are very talented and we did a great job.
The communication paid off. Thanks so much.
Allie, thank you as always. And that'll wrap it up, folks. For Allie LaForce, Clark Kellogg, and Grant Hill, this is Brian Anderson thanking you for watching the NBA presented by 2K Sports. We'll see you next time.